What's up, everybody? This is PDH with Love on Tour. Hope everybody's doing well. This is a review of the all-inclusive, adult-only, five-star luxury resort, the El Carmen in the Dominican Republic, Punta Cana. The resort is large and sprawling with over 492 suites that either have a pool or ocean view. It has 12 restaurants, 24-hour room service, and nightly entertainment. Unlimited drinks and food throughout your stay. The one thing to know about the resort is that it is huge. It was a large resort with a lot of swimming pools right on the ocean. Upon arriving in the lobby, we were met with champagne and cool towels while we waited to check in. So that was a very cool welcome. We stayed in the 800 square foot junior suite with club level access, which had a special floor for drinks and appetizers available only to the club guests, which was kind of cool. The bathroom was large with a rainfall showerhead, double master sinks. We had a very deep and comfortable jacuzzi on the balcony, which we got significant use out of. The room had premium liquor, wine selections, and one of the cool things in the room was that the room service window, which allowed the staff to place food in it without having to enter the room. The balcony was also large with its own seating area. Now, the grounds were sprawling. There were swimming pools everywhere, even swimming pools there attached to some of the rooms, which was very cool. I found that just walking around the resort, it felt tropical. It was very well maintained. The plants and the trees were all healthy. Beach was a straight shot from our room straight down to the sand. The gym was large and had everything I needed to work out. As you all know, I like to get my workout on when I'm on vacation. The resort was even more glamorous and beautiful with the lighting, up lighting everywhere on plants and on the rooms coming off. The swimming pools again had a beautiful blue glow to them, which was very cool. I enjoyed also that they had a special day set aside where they did like this carnival right there on the beach. They did food and they cooked right there on the beach and they had dancers and it was very cool. It was a nice touch. There were places to eat everywhere. Again, it had 12 restaurants and most of them were pretty good. We loved the Italian restaurant, was one of our favorites. They paired our meal with some phenomenal wine that we really enjoyed. The coffee spot was absolutely fantastic. We really enjoyed that. The coffee was good. They had some sweets there, and you know I have a sweet tooth. But it was a great little place to get your day started. As with most all-inclusive resorts, they had a lot of the activities included with some kayaking and snorkeling and things of that nature. The nightlife was cool. They always had something going on, a singer here or there, a piano going in the bar, a saxophonist, a band out near the beach. I thought that was a very nice touch, but be warned that about 10 o'clock, the resort shuts down. There's nothing that's going on late night there. They also did this awesome Michael Jackson tribute, and I thought the performer was really good. They had other dancers come on and join him, and it was in their outdoor theater, which I thought was a good show. So we give the El Carmen a lover's score of 4.5 stars. So here are some things that we didn't like. The entertainment was very nicely done. It just ended very early in the night. By 10 o'clock, the resort was absolutely dead. The other thing was the language barrier was sometimes a little taxing. There were some staff that didn't speak English at all. Now here's a sum up. The resort was very remote, making for tranquil times. This is a place that you can go and seriously relax. How relaxing was it? The beach service was amazing. And here's a tip, if you're a drinker, add an extra shot on the side. The drinks were a little bit on the lighter side, but they did have top shelf available. Take advantage of the hobby cats and water sports. We didn't get a chance to do a lot of that stuff, but it's free and you should take advantage of it. Bars were everywhere, lots of places to drink if you're into that. During the day and the evening, there were lots of options for live music, and there was always plenty of beach seating. Sometimes at these resorts, the beach seating gets taken up first. People reserve the seats or there's just not enough available. But here we found we could always get a nice seat somewhere near the water. Never really felt crowded to us, although they said they were near capacity. So that gives you some context in terms of how large the resort actually was. Nearby, there was some awesome horseback riding available, which we took advantage of. And if you're going to do the excursions, the concierge there at the hotel can help you with this. And they were very, very attentive to our needs, and they were great. So if you're looking for a vacation on the land where you can really enjoy yourself and have a good time and have everything included and get a great value for your money, we do recommend the El Carmen as a great choice. So that's it for this episode of Love on Tour. This is PDH, and remember, it's love above all.